Good morning, guys. How are you? How have you been? I hope all of you are doing well. This is our very first class and I'm teaching you the paper, Introducing Literature. This is the core paper that you have for this semester, one of the most important papers in the whole semester, probably one of your stepping stones into the world of literature. There'll be two other teachers who will be dealing with the paper along with me, who will be discussing diverse aspects of the paper. But initially, I personally am discussing the one part, the third module, which is literature and ideology. But before we delve into the details of the module and what the contents of the module are, let me give you a very brief introduction about literary studies and some personal notions that I have about literary studies. I hope you know that my name is Amal, Amal Dev PJ, and I'm the junior most faculty in the Department of English. And we will be having so many classes together throughout your degree life. And I'm very happy that this is going to be your first core class and I'll be engaging it. I'm also slightly sad that it's not a real life class where we could have interacted so much. We could have had so much of fun. You could have given me your perspectives about literature, literary studies, and the books that you love and all. So let's begin. Now, I do not know how many of you read that much. Do you guys read? And what kind of works do you read? Do you read very deep and very emotionally appealing works? Or is it very happy and feel-good literary works that you read? Or are you people who are more into cinema? Cinema is, in a way, an amazing art form like literature also. Cinema can actually be called the literature of the modern day even. So, any kind of artistic representation is, in a way, a beautiful form of communication of ideas to our fellow human beings. So, when we read literature, there are many things that happen in our minds. That is, reading a book is not just about pleasure. Most of the time, we do not understand the depth of the processes that are happening when you are reading a work of literature. When you take up a book and read about the life of a character and how the character goes through life, makes decisions, how he behaves to certain other characters and how he feels during certain occasions, we probably empathize with the character. We start to think from their perspective and we feel bad for them. We feel happy when they get something nice. All these things happen. Why actually does one have to go through all these things? You think of it this way. As human beings, our lives are quite limited. The kind of experiences that you yourself can have is very limited. Now, if I'm born into Kerala, into a middle-class family, the kind of lived experiences that I might have is in a way already defined. I might go to a school, a nearby school, and I might eventually get a job, get married. And so there is a predetermined trajectory of life, which if we try to make a lot of effort can change drastically. I can create amazing things in my life if I have the willpower to do that. But even then, many of the experiences that you will have in your childhood and in your younger days are actually determined by your circumstances. But there is a possibility through which you can actually explore many things which may never be part of your life. That is, when you read a work of literature, you're reading Harry Potter. Imagine, you're living in a magical land, a magical school where there are students who have amazing magical skills. This is something that will never happen in your life, but you got to live a bit of it through your mind, through your imagination, through literature. Now, that's one positive example. There are other very significant examples. There are many people who have very difficult experiences in life also. For example, probably the migrants in Palestine presently, or probably transgenders who have very difficult experiences in their lives. So we personally may never encounter that difficult experiences, that traumatic experiences. But when we read through literature about their lives, their stories, we actually learn to empathize with them. Now when we read the story of Anne Frank probably, we learn that the kind of atrocities that they had to go through, and we feel connected to them in some way. We feel empathy towards them in some way. And probably if I'm a male and I read something written by a female, I understand what their perspective on life is or what their experiences with life are, and I empathize with them. So this is one significant aspect about studying literature, empathy. That is, when you're reading a work of literature, you're not just reading an imaginative piece of fiction that is out there, but you're also going into an amazing journey into the lives of those characters, into the decisions of those characters, into an entirely different life, an entirely different life from your own. So this is something amazing. If some pages of a book can do this to you, how amazing is that? So literature is an amazing pursuit to follow at this point of time. So what I want you to do is comment below your favorite book, whichever it is, or your favorite poem or a story, whichever is your favorite work of literature, comment it below and let me see how many wide varieties of works you come up with. And then we will go into the next video. Thank you.